What's up, everybody? It's me, Erica, and this is your Bridgington episode 3 review. We are making our way through the episode. As you can see, I am doing a review every other day, so you get Bridgington and then Bling Empire. We'll have Bling Empire tomorrow, and also Salt Lake City tomorrow. I watched a bit of Salt Lake City. Girl, it's a mess. Anyways, so let's get into Bridgington. We start off, we open with Daphne having a dream about Simon. So we're already on the third episode, and we can basically see that she is starting to like him. And what is actually very natural for people who spend time with one another and get to know each other, they start to become fond of one another. So she's having this dream about Simon. She wakes up all flushed. Now, what Lady Whistledown is writing and says that Daphne has turned down 3 suitors, so clearly she must be waiting for the rake to propose to her, because he has not proposed yet. She tells Simon that she still needs to find her match. So she keeps Daphne keeps delaying meeting a person, because people are coming up to her. Three people have proposed to her and she has declined. So to me, I feel like, well, she wants someone high in stature and high in status. And I feel like clearly you like Simon, because if the goal is to get married and 3 people have proposed to you, why are you waiting for him to propose to you? And that was the agreement from day one, you're not getting married. It was a ruse. It's a ruse. So, but it's natural. Lady Whistledown lets us know that the prince is coming. A prince of Prussia is coming to visit the town. Penelope is looking for some mail. She's going down to the mail thing, scrambling through envelopes. And she's looking for a letter from Spain for Marina. She tells Marina, she goes upstairs, there's no letter. She's like, he hasn't written back to me. So she's kind of upset. She falls on the bed. She's upset about it. She's like, the guy that got her pregnant hasn't responded to her yet. He's off in war fighting in Spain. So here comes Lady Featherington, and she tells Marina, let me tell you something. You're going to have to re-enter society, because your condition is going to get worse. And so we need to marry you off right away. Get to it. Let's get you down there. Let's get you some dresses. Let's find you a husband. And she's looking like, okay, I guess I don't have no other choice, because you don't have any other choice, but we'll see. She was like, whatever. So in the Bridgington household, the Duke, they're talking about how the Duke hasn't proposed yet. The mother, in their conversation, the mother says, it's easy to pick who you want to marry, because you pick the person who's your best friend. You pick the one that you are best friends with. That's how you find, it's easy. That's how you find who you want to marry. And they're looking like, it's not that easy. And she's like, yes, it is. It's that easy. Find the person who's going to be your best friend. So they're at the ball, and somebody's asking Daphne to dance, and Simon makes this outward expression of jealousy so the people around can see. And she was like, oh, that was good. You acting jealous? That's great. So the guys are asking her to dance, and she's dancing, and she's asking questions, like trying to get to know these guys. And they're just like, oh, I haven't even thought about that. She was like, well, where do you plan on living? And where do you, questions. And they're like, haven't thought about that. Their only goal is to find a wife. And that's it. They don't give a damn who it is. As long as she can uplift their status, they don't give a damn who it is. They really don't. And so she's not having any luck with any of the guys. And she keeps looking over at Simon like, these guys are a mess. And he's looking like, girl, I know I'm the best one in town, honey. They're talking, and the queen arrives, and the prince of Prussia is with the queen. And of course, Lady Cowper, who is kind of the unattractive rich girl who her mother is very desperate to marry her off. That's what's going on with Lady Cowper. And so they're talking about how Lady Cowper's her antics and her techniques to get the eye of the prince, and how she's going to drop her eyes, and she's going to drop her gaze, and then she's going to look up at him, and then she's going to put her fan next to her breast so he can look at her. And Simon and Daphne are like a ways, and they're clocking Lady Cowper's techniques. They're just doing, and they're laughing about it. They're like, it's predictable. She's predictable. Then the prince comes over to introduce himself to Daphne, and he does everything that, like, Daphne and Simon said he was going to do, and so Daphne ends up laughing in his face. And the queen is looking like, girl, this is the prince. I said that you're the diamond, you're the incomparable, and you sitting up here laughing in this man's face. And so the queen rushes him off. Okay. So Sienna and the Modiste is, they're talking. And basically, Sienna, you know, she goes with Anthony Bridgerton. And she says that she needs to stay with the Modiste until she finds a man who she can stay with or who can come visit her. And so she's like, I'm going to take it into my own hands. I deserve, you know, this is what I deserve. We, you know, we're women who basically make our own way. We're not strapped to these traditions or anything like that. She says she's going to find her a good man. So, you know, because her and Anthony done broke up, remember? Okay. So Simon and Anthony are sitting down talking. He's like, I'm glad we're talking again, you know. He's like, but you know, I don't have any ill will towards your sister. I wouldn't make a fool out of her. You know, you should know me better than that, I'm not going to make a fool out of her. All of a sudden, they're in this gentleman bar and, you know, lounge or whatever. And all these women start coming in, right? With their fans and their, honey, and their tendrils falling down on their shoulders, honey. And they're doing all, you know. And so Sienna, who used to fuck with Anthony, she comes over to Simon and she's all in his face. And she was like, yeah, I'm an opera singer. And they talking back and forth. And she was like, why don't you come see me after the opera? And I'll come sing on your dick, basically, is what she was saying. And he was looking like, and so Anthony is in the corner looking like this. I know this motherfucker didn't invite Simon to the opera later. So that's what's going on. And Anthony is over there looking all crazy. So in the next scene, Daphne, she can't sleep. She goes down to get some milk, some warm milk. And she sees Anthony in the hallway. He was like, you want me to call somebody to come get it for you? She was like, no, I'll get it myself. So they're down in the kitchen with the milk. They don't know what to do. She was like, well, what do you do? Light the stove on fire. He was like, I don't know how to light the stove on fire. They do not know, honey. They so rich, they don't know how to light the damn stove on fire. That is crazy. She starts asking questions about Simon. And she was like, so why is he so hell-bent on not getting married? And Anthony is like, listen, he's a complicated person. His mother died. His father was an asshole. Lady Danbury basically raised him. He's been alone all his life. And I think he actually prefers it that way. And at the end of the day, he spent his entire life alone. And some people aren't just meant to be with each other. So now we can see that Daphne is interested in why Simon doesn't want to get married. I don't know why she just doesn't ask him. Did she ask him? I don't remember. He basically tells her some people aren't meant together, but he's also thinking about Sienna in the back of his mind as well. So Lady Whistledown is writing that the prince is in town and the women are gathered around him. They're acting up. They're acting a fool. So Miss Thompson is meeting suitors, and they're all these old men. Like, she's Featherington brings this old ass man. I mean, like, old, like, not old as Fairbrook, but old, like older, like his daddy. And she's looking like, no, I don't like him. So she's being rude to the people on purpose. So they'll be like, ooh, get away, you know, you're rude. I've never seen such a beautiful girl be so rude and shit like that. So the prince sees Daphne, right? The Prince of Prussia. Now he sees Daphne. He makes his way over to Daphne, and he starts speaking to her. So they're having small talk, and she was like, oh, you know, do you like coming to London? And this and that, small talk. And then she sees Simon off to the back, like walking behind, and she gets distracted, and the prince notices, and he's like, okay. And she was like, well, you know, go find you a wife, honey. I'll see you later. So he's kind of intrigued because she's not acting like the way the rest of the women are acting. She's not being desperate and thirsty. And she walks away. And so she goes into another room. They're in like a museum. And she goes into another like hall. And Simon is in there. He's looking at art. And he's looking up at this one particular piece. And they're actually faced the opposite way. And they're both looking at art. And, you know, they really can't be alone. So they're very like, you know, in this other room or whatever. And she was like, isn't it great that we are fooling Miss Whistledown? And he was like, yeah, it's a great thing. And we're doing really well fooling her, aren't we? And he was like, yeah, we are. So he's looking at this one particular picture and she starts asking about it. And it's actually something that he gave for the museum. What do you call it? Donated artwork for the museum. And he's sitting there talking about it. And I guess he says it's kind of his mom's favorite. And then Daphne starts describing her interpretation of the picture. And he's like into it, really into it. And then they're so into it that their hands are kind of, they're now facing, of course, facing the same direction. And their hands kind of touch each other. And they touch each other and they're grabbing each other. So it's a little intimate thing. And it's dope because she's like in the middle of describing art. And he's connecting to her with that. That was kind of dope. So all of a sudden you hear this gasp come out the other room. And so Simon and Daphne go running off. And of course, Lady Cowper, she didn't fall on the ground, honey. She didn't faint. So then the prince is over there picking her up off the ground. She's fainting. Everybody's looking like, ooh, that was good. She did that good. She got him. Honey, she swoons and falls out. So after that, the driver for Simon says, do you want me to take you to the opera? And I remember Sienna has offered for him to come to the opera to have a little nightcap after. And he says no. So there you have it. He says no. He was about to go get his back broke by the opera singer. He was like, no, I'm cool. I'm going to go home. Let's go home. So they go home. Now the queen is talking to the prince of Prussia and she's like, look, I have told everybody that Daphne is that girl. So what you are going to have to do is learn how to charm her, okay? He was like, well, I think, according to Lady Whistledown, she's in love with Simon. She already has somebody. She was like, no, let me tell you something. The heart doesn't matter as long as the hand is free. You're a prince. Charm her ass. What the hell is wrong with you? And Eloise and Daphne are having a conversation with each other, and they're just talking about, you know, what's going on in society. And Eloise is completely, she doesn't understand why it's so important to get married. She doesn't understand. She's again rejecting this tradition. And she tells Daphne, you know, it's not my fault that you are following your heart and I want to nurture my mind. That's what I want to do. I just don't understand. Because even when Lady Cowper fainted and was down on the ground, Eloise was looking around like, y'all don't see this shit. She was not here for it. She's totally rejected. I love Eloise. She is the actual character that I identify with the most because she is just like, this is dumb. I don't want to do this stuff. I want to go off to school. I want to feed my brain. I don't give a damn what is going on with these men and all of this stuff because it doesn't mean nothing. And look what you have to do. So I'm down with it. I love Eloise. I'm here for her. So later, Lady Featherin takes Marina to the hood, basically. And she was like, girl, let me tell you something. If you don't get married, this is what your life is going to be like. And Marina was like, girl, you think you're going to take me down here with some hardworking people and make me feel a certain way about not being married? And she goes, look, you want your kids to be like that? And it was a little boy sitting on the ground with the little thing begging for change. And she was looking nervous and she was like, oh, okay, like whatever. So she was upset about that. And she was like, let me tell you something. I'm gonna tell you, she was like, well, he loves me. She was like, has your man of war, has he written back to you? She was like looking crazy. She was like, let me tell you something. Men, when they want to fuck, basically, is what she was saying. When they want to fuck, they will tell you anything. They will be all in love with you. But when the consequences of their lovemaking shows up, they will fall out of love with you, girl. Hello? I said, come on, Lady Featherton. You better let her know. You better let her ass know. These niggas will tell you anything to hop in the bed with you. That's what she basically told her. In so many words, honey. They're at the promenade and Daphne and Simon are walking around. And so she tells him, my mom comes up with this concept that you should marry your friend. What do you think about that? And he was like, I guess it's okay. And she was like, but aren't there other things to marriage and intangible things and regular things? And so they were just having this conversation. It was very cute. And then she talked about what other things happen in a marriage? And he was like, it just amazes me how mothers don't tell their daughters anything. And she was like, what are you talking about? Tell me what happens. Like, I need to know. Like, she literally does not know. And it's, I don't even know why they would do such a disservice to their daughters, not telling them about themselves, not telling them about sex, not telling them how babies are, not telling them nothing. I don't understand. Like, I just don't get why they don't do that. Somebody please explain in the comments. I just don't get it. So anyways, she was like, well, Simon was like, let me explain to you. It's what happens in the night, you know, but it's a little more than that. And she was like, what? Like, what do you mean what happens in the night? Baby, Simon starts explaining to her how to get familiar with herself, baby. And he was like up in her face and he was like, okay, touch your body. And he starts explaining to her and he's in her face and she's like, what? She's like, girl, what the hell? He was like, okay, when you touch yourself. And she was like, touch myself. He was like, you don't touch yourself? And she was like, no. He was like, touch yourself between your legs. And when it starts to feel good, don't stop. And that should help you. And then somebody calls him. It's so funny. He's like, and that should help you. And then when he starts walking away, he was like, come. I was like, come on, Simon. Simon is fine as hell. He is so cute to me. Lady Danbury asked him, listen, are you going to propose to her or not? Because she has a prince that's interested in her. And if you fuck this up for her, I'm going to be really mad at you. So if you don't have any intentions on marrying her or proposing to her, let her ass go so she can marry this prince. Period. So he's looking like he's conflicted, right? And because he's made a vow, right? Remember, he's made a vow and he has to honor his word that he made. But he's starting to like Daphne too. They're starting to like each other. I mean, it's inevitable, really. It really is. So Eloise and Benedict are having a talk about both of them being non-traditional, basically. And she just lets him know, listen, you're a man. The things that you say that you can't do, you can do. You're a man in this society. You can do whatever the hell you want to. That I can't do that. And she was like, and I could live vicariously through you. So I don't understand why you're not doing what you want to do when you're a man. So any excuse that you coming up with for not doing anything, it ain't hitting nowhere because you're a man in this society and you can do whatever the hell you want to do. And then he asked her, are you Lady Whistledown? And she was like, if I was, why would I tell you, basically? But she's not. We know that she's not because she's trying to figure out who Lady Whistledown is. Next scene, honey, Daphne is getting her freaky. She's getting familiar with herself. So she gets familiar with herself while she's thinking about Simon, thinking about him giving her a rose, thinking about all these things. So she has her first orgasm, honey. And so the next day, she's in the town and she sees Simon on the street and they're standing next to each other. And he's very, like, you know, very formal with her. And he's like, listen, we can't see each other anymore. This is over with. And she was like, what? Why? And it's so funny the way they did it because it was, to me, it felt like it was after she masturbated, she thought about him, and the next day, he's like, I don't want to see you anymore. And so she was like, was this about the conversation that we had yesterday? And he was like, yeah, and I should not have that conversation with you. And she was like, he was like, no, but I should not have had that conversation with you. He was like, the prince likes you, so go be with your prince, because the prince likes you, I'm just standing in your way. You know what our intentions were. It was a diversion. It was, you know, we were playing a game and I have to leave town anyway. So go be with your prince. The prince likes you. Go holler at him. He was really mad about it. She was mad about it. She was very upset. She's crying and everything like that. So at the opera, Sienna sees Anthony and Anthony goes in the backs and he's talking to her and he basically asks her, are you fucking with Simon? And she was like, that's the only reason why you're here. That's fucked up. He was like, no, I'm here because, you know, I really care about you and I really love you. She was like, no, you're here because you thought I was going to fuck with one of your friends. And that's what's really fucked up. She was like, but you know what? Where my decision still stands, I don't want you in my life. I'm done with this. I'm done. You broke your promise to me. I'm tired of your shit and I'm tired of looking like a damn fool. Goodbye. Get out of here. Go. And he leaves. Penelope gets in the mail, honey. She gets the mail and she sees a letter from Spain. She runs upstairs to Marina, shows her the letter. Marina reads the letter and the letter says that he's not coming back. He doesn't know what she's talking about. That don't have nothing to do with me. That baby don't have nothing to do with me. I don't know what you're talking about. So she's crying and upset. But as it turns out, Lady Featherington and her servant helped write this letter to Marina. So the man hadn't wrote Marina. It was somebody else. It was the mama. And so she was like, well, you can hear Marina crying off in the background. She's crying. And she was like, do you think it worked? She was like, yes. And she was like, eventually somebody was going to have to tell her how men were. And he probably, if he does come to town, he's not going to be checking for her. She's pregnant. Ain't nobody worried about her. So Marina is upset. So at the Modistas, they're getting their dresses fitted. Daphne is getting her dresses fitted, and Lady Cowper is there. And Lady Cowper tells Lady Bridgerton, hey, listen, I know the prince is interested in your daughter, but my daughter is also interested in him. And, you know I have the money, but your daughter has the face. So the mother really wants her to be with Simon. I don't understand. If somebody can explain to me, I don't understand why she's so hell-bent on her being with Simon. I guess because he's a duke or whatever. But Daphne overhears it, and she's like, okay, I'm just a pretty face. All right, so I'm going to the ball tonight. I'm about to have my best dress on. She tells her handmaid, hey, lady, make my hair the way you like it. Give me the curls. Give me the crown. Give me the white dress. Let's do this. So she's getting ready for the ball. Mama Bridgerton goes in and talks to Anthony, and she lets him know, it's about your time to start looking for a wife. What you getting ready to do? Time is of the essence. Chop, chop. Stop playing around in here. So at the ball, the prince and Lady Cowper are talking and having a conversation. Daphne comes in and she shuts the place down, honey. She comes in over the balcony, and so everybody's looking up at her. Simon is looking. The prince is looking. And the prince stops talking to Lady Cowper and walks to the bottom of the stairs so he can meet Daphne down there. And he was like, I have to have your first dance, sweetheart. Sweetheart, I have to have your first dance. And she was like, oh, sure. And then she drops her fan, honey. So he bends down on one knee and he gets her fan, and everybody's looking like, God damn it, this bitch. Simon was looking crazy. The queen was pleased, honey. So basically they just said, you know, why would you settle for a duke when you can have a prince, honey? And you saw Simon walking off. Simon is pissed. And that was it, y'all. That was it. It was a good episode. I enjoyed the episode overall. So we're going to see what's going to happen on the next review. Go ahead and leave your comments down in the comment section. Let me know what you think of this episode. If you guys can explain to me, because I don't get it, why Mama Bridgerton is like so hell-bent on Daphne getting with the Duke. Does she just see that as her only option? Because she does see other men proposing to her, but why are they so hell-bent on the Duke? But, honey, the prince was looking at her like, baby, I got to have your dance, honey. She was like, sure. And all the things her and Simon were making fun of Lady Cowper, she was like, I'm going to play this game. Y'all want to play? I'm going to play. Because since y'all say I have face, I'm down here with this face. Protect your energy. Peace.